Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be showing you how to make stairs in SketchUp. We're going to delete our scale figure here. And the first thing that you want to make sure that you understand is the floor-to-floor height in whatever you're doing. So we're going to just draw a line here. Maybe we'll make it a rectangle and make this a group. And then we're going to put this up. Let's say it's a weird amount, 12 foot, 2.5. Right. So this is, our floor that we're going between. Let's say it's like an overhang or something. So we want to get from here to here, and that is our, the stairs that we're gonna need. Let's actually bring this down a little bit. We're just gonna do a single run, keep it a little simple for now. In a future video, I may make a more complex stair. So let's take our tape measure tool and we're gonna check. So we have 9'2.5". And it could actually be even more weird than that. So let's move it down, let's say 3/32. So how weird is it? Okay, so this like super odd number here. What you want to do is look at your local code or what your township, ask them what code is applicable, if this is an actual project, obviously. And then you want to check and make sure that you're verifying. Typically a tread is about, let's say a foot, we'll just be a little bit safe, by let's say 3 foot wide. I do that the wrong way. Group. Actually, I want to make this a component. Tread. That's what we'll call that. So we have our tread here. Now what you want to do is sort of basically figure out what your maximum riser is. So that's the vertical part of your tread. So if I take that tread I just made and I copy it all the way down so that it's on the surface, and then I hit divide, let's say 10. So I just took a guess there. I'm gonna measure this, and that's about 11 feet, or 11 inches, sorry. And that's way too much, so we're gonna undo that, do it again. We're gonna look for somewhere around 7 inches. So I think that was 10, so let's try divide, that's the backslash or the forward slash key, 15, and let's see what our tread height is here. So that's much closer to 7. Let's just add a few more. We had 15, let's say 18. 18 treads here. So M for move, moving it down, divide 18. So now we're around 6, and that's perfectly fine as well. So now we have all of these. I can actually delete the rest of these because I have that spacing. The thing that I care about is just the spacing. So now I have that dimension here. If I select this, copy it there, choose 17, you can see if I extend this out a little bit. There we go. I have all of my treads. They're perfectly spaced. And then if I just want to do the same thing with the risers, or because this is a component, I can actually just draw like that and then delete this bottom guy. So that's the basic shape of my treads. Now what I like to do for the riser, or not the riser, the stringer, what I like to do for that is use an actual shape. So if you think of this as being, if you need a stringer, it's got to be one piece, right? So I'm just going to take this off to the side really quick. Let me just make it a group and rotate it. So if we make this and then take this shape, rotate, Q for rotate, the up arrow to lock to that axis. There we go. So if we were to lay down this stair and we want to draw a shape here, essentially what we're looking for with the stringer is an actual size, and that'll help give some realism to what's going on. So let's say we have a 2 by 12. A 2 by 12 is about 1.5. The actual size of it is about 1.5 by 11.25. So we're just going to choose 11.25 by. This size shouldn't really matter all that much. Okay, so we have that size, and then we can just actually just pull this out and extend that down. And I think just doing the stair like this helps me understand what's going on. So we have the dimension here, the length doesn't really matter. Let's draw the shape first. So let's just cut this guy out. And then we can copy him down. So let's times this by 20. That's more than we need, but that's fine. We can just delete the extra. So I'm just going to hit the E for the eraser tool and then just delete all these little guys. I'm sure there's a quicker way to do that. You could always do something like that. And then when we get to the top here, after this tread, we don't need anything else. So I'm just going to come down. I want to come down here. So I'm just going to copy over this line. So then it gives me that purple line, the perpendicular line. And delete the top here. And then with the bottom, we have too many, which is fine. We just want to extend this line back because it's flat on the bottom, right? Your stringer has to sit on the ground. Okay. So that's basically a stringer. And then we're going to take that and we're going to extrude it 1.5 inches because, that's what we got. Now we have a perfect stringer. That's going to look really nice when we put it in here. So I'm just going to make a copy. Actually, let me make this a component first. So stringer. And then come over to here. Hit Q for the rotate tool. And I'm just going to line everything up. Right. Green. So there we go with that. And then I can just copy this over. Now what happens here is that you can see my stringer through because I have my stringers are face-based and my treads and risers are not. So obviously you can come in, just extrude this up a little bit. Let me move this stringer in. Okay. Extrude this out. So let's say this is, a half inch. And this is up a half inch. And then, you know, you might want a little bit of like a round at the end. So let's push this out just a teeny tiny bit. And then if you wanted it to be round, you could always draw this circle here. Extrude that along. I'm gonna hit E for the eraser tool and then hit Control to hide that line. And then if this is too far, like I think that is just a little too much, just bring it back. Let's try something more like that. Obviously, you might want to finick with this a little bit. So maybe I want this to be like that. So I see the edge here. But this gives you the fundamental part of your stairs. And maybe I don't want a top. I want this to be unique, a unique component. And I don't want there to be a top piece. Ooh, just extrude this. Maybe the floor is then, you know, the floor turns into that instead of the it being an actual tread. So we're not going to do the railing today, but this should give you a good idea of how to create some stairs. I like doing it measuring the floor first, because that's typically how stairs are done anyway. You're not going to pick a number that I want my risers to be 7 inches, because it's never exact. So you just want to be careful. Make sure that your stairs are within code if you're doing it for an actual project. But it's a quick way without having to get out a calculator to figure out how many steps you're going to need. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.